Hey everyone, Mr. Fish Angler here. Another video for you guys. Today I'm going to be talking about drop shotting. It's winter. Some people can still fish. In Canada, ice is frozen. I can't. Waiting for ice fishing. I'm going to make a video about drop shotting, what I use, how I do it, and everything you need to know, or everything I know, or I use. So I'm going to start off by telling you the baits I have, going from smallest to biggest, drop shotting it. Eventually how I drop shot or what line I use, and I'm going to show you a few in the tank test, so stay tuned. This is the box I normally use right here. Just a 360 tackle box. You're going to be seeing this more. This is all the stuff I use a lot. I'm going to start off with Set the Hook Slinky. There'll be a nice picture of Set the Hook. It's a Canadian company, Hamport company, originating in Canada. This bait's called the Slinky. It's a panfish bait. Flat on one side. It's like a slinky. You see here, really nice bend to it there. Comes in 5 different colors. My favorite is right here. The white, where is it? Sorry about this. It's a white and chartreuse, so it's white, but with a chartreuse tail. Great color, and drop shot this lightweight, light action tackle. Put a little hook through the nose, and drop shot this for panfish. Now move on to this next size up. Next bait I got here is the Set the Hook Slaptail Grub. This is Set the Hook's paddle stick or paddle stick bait, paddle tail version. Again, it's a hand pour, so you're going to have one flat side, which is still totally fishable, does not affect anything. And for drop shotting, it doesn't affect it at all. This is not too much longer, I believe. It's 3.5 inches. Nice thin profile, but strong enough and thick to work. With an oversized tail right here, or paddle, you have a tremendous wounded bait fish type of look. Crazy action, moves a lot of water. Put this on a jig. I also like to drop shot it. Again, light tackle. Go for bass, go for some big panfish on this. Some really nice action. You can just tell that tail will be thumping like crazy. So that's the Slaptail Grub. I Set the Hook. Now I'll move on to the next bait. As we move along, these baits are getting bigger in size. This one is a 3.75 inch, so 0.25 bigger than the last one. This is Set the Hook's Crush Worm. Again, so Set the Hook, this has some... ...import products. This is the Crush Worm right here. True drop shotting bait. Flat on one side. If you can focus on it, you probably can't. But they're just loaded with salt. Really nice tail, cool design on it, gives a great action. I'll show this one in the tank. You can just see, holding it by the tip, look how much that bends down. That's the skin, great in the water. I'll show you this. This came out in 2011. So this is a great bait, comes in pack of 10. You can pick these up. This is like a bluish gray and white pattern. Guys, I didn't miss one, so we're going back. This is the Set the Hook Stumpy Crush Worm. It's 3.5 inches long. Again, it's kind of like the other bait I just showed you. This color here is one of my favorite colors. We have a gray or like a natural color, and there's a purple stripe here. These baits, you look really close. Crazy salt in there. This is a thicker bait, like the other one. Unlike the other one. Bit stiffer action, but it's still great. You're going to have a nice tail action there. And think about drop shotting, a lot of people do. they do some crazy action. They move the bait along the water. But with the Set the Hook products, if you just leave them still, let the natural currents, let the water, just let it do its thing. Let it sit motionless. It'll give a light twitch. It'll work great. Next bait here, and the biggest, I don't use these a lot. We have another hand pour company here. You can find this guy on YouTube. Big Boy Baits. Hand pour company originated like over YouTube. This is the Big Boy Baits needle. Not sure how long it is, but it's gonna be like a bait I'm gonna show you later. Circle. We have a thick head here, and right about here it tapers down to a tail like that. So this is gonna give a great moving action in the water. Yet to try these, but I've seen great videos on these. Check these out. Finally, we have the Power Team Lures Finicky Tickler. This is in pure black. They make multiple colors. If you see on here, some ribs. Also tapers down. This is shorter. Flat bottom. This great hook and nose. You got great drop shot bait. What you can also do with this is you can shaky head it, throw this on a jig, you can Texas rig it. So it's a very versatile bait. So now for the line, hooks, and weights. Generally, for drop shotting, I like to use medium to light line. Here I'm using Sunline Super Sniper FC Fluorocarbon. This is 8 pound. And So here's my setup I have here. Got my 8 pound line, it's hard to see here. But at the very bottom is where your weight's gonna be when you're drop shotting. This is a tungsten weight. And the line just goes into there and hooks in. You're generally gonna want a drop shot bait that's round and slick. There's ones that are cylinders, there's ones like these. I recommend both of those because when you're dragging this along the bottom, they're gonna get bumped up. They're gonna go on rocks, and having it circular instead of getting stuck on the rocks, it'll just kind of roll over it or drag over it. So I recommend that. Then you can see my hook here. You generally want from your hook to your weight, depending on what you're fishing and where you're fishing or how deep it is, you're gonna want it 6 to 8 inches. Six or more inches above. If you're trying to target a certain spot, obviously find that depth, find where you want to put it, make that your weight from your hook, make sure it's at the right spot. Right here for demonstration, I'm at 8.5 inches. This is pretty good for anything. Generally, from 6 to 8 inches will be where you're drop shotting. A lot of people have personal preferences. You can hook it just a little bit through and have it right down there. You can skin hook it. You can put it a little bit farther. It's personal preference. Generally, you're hooking it in the nose and letting it have a lot of action. Even right there, just like that, is good. I'm not the greatest at skin hooking, so I couldn't achieve that there. If you put it a little farther back and skin hook it, don't worry about it swiveling around. Underwater, it'll be alright. But just even in the hook, look how much that bends over. That's gonna have great action underwater. So everyone, here's the tank test. I did have to change it a little bit, the length, because for it to fit in the tank. And the bait, I have it tilted a little to one side towards the glass so you can see it better. So I'll show you the drop-in. So you can see this bait, you want to keep your line not too loose because then it's going to go weird. You want to keep it a little tight, so not tension, but have a little hold on it. And as you can see here, I'm not even moving it. You can see that small tail action right there. Just fluttering. This could be from your hand shaking, anything moving. Even this, will catch fish. That's deadly right there. You don't want to overwork it, because that's just going to scare the fish. Like, depending on your situation, that's going to scare the fish. So, light twitches is what I like to do. A few twitches. Pause it. I sometimes like to pull it up and then let it dive down a little like that. But really, I don't like overworking this bait. Just some light twitches, move it along. It's great. And see, it floats there really nicely. And then if I start to lose slack, it sags down like that. That could work too for catching fish. So it's a nice wave action in the bait. And that just gets the bass's attention, and they're gonna want to bite that lure. So my tips for drop shotting: medium setups, bit longer rod, circular weights. Just pick a lure you like for drop shotting. Different lengths for different size fish generally. And just try it out. It takes practice. So thank you guys for watching.